pay. So I guess that's a first question. You know, how are some of the firms out there that are buying practices for these large multiples, how are they making the money work?
So it's a great question. And let's put some context around it, right? I mean, at what point in time is it too expensive? And when we think about that, you know, here we are in February of 2023 and the, you know, February 21st of 2023, and we're looking at companies like NVIDIA and Tesla that are trading upwards of a 50 times next year's earnings. And how is that, you know, is that too expensive or not? And it's always relative to the time period. You know, I think what's interesting about companies, you know, and if we look a year ago, those companies were trading even higher, you know, certainly from a stock price perspective, because they're down a lot from their 52-week highs, both of them are. And yet they're now trading at 50 times next year's earnings again. And so is that too expensive? Again, there's a relativity to it. What we've seen with the massive amounts of private equity money, and now it's also not just private equity money, but also private family office money that's coming into the marketplace. The reason there's so much money coming into the RIA and broker-dealer and strategic acquiring marketplace, and the reason the multiples have gone up at these firms, is because of growth rate, right? So ultimately, when we think about an NVIDIA or a Tesla, it really comes back to these companies are growing at such a feverish pace that that's why their stock price trades it so high. You know, so when we think about some of these strategic acquiring firms that could be going at a 20 times EBITDA, 22 times EBITDA, even as much as 24 and 25 times EBITDA, which are untold, unheard of prices, how is that possible? Well, because they're growing. We see them growing at 200% and 300% growth every 2-3 years. And when we think about the mergers and acquisitions and kind of the consolidating of the financial advisor space, you know, by all accounts, certainly by my account, we're still in the second or third inning of a 9-inning game, right? So there's a lot more consolidation that's yet to happen. And that's why we're seeing so much institutional money coming into the space, which is pushing up price at the higher end. And beyond pushing up price at the higher end, that's also increasing price at the lower end because companies want to compete for that business. So when we think about, you know, a typical $150 million financial advisory practice that's doing, you know, $1 million, $1.25 million of revenue, in the past that would have been maybe 2 times revenue. And it's certainly not today at 7 or 8, as we were talking about, times revenue. But these firms are getting priced out at a multiple on EBITDA, right, which is really free cash flow. And if we then take that math of what's their top line revenue, what are their expenses, what is the EBITDA, and or just said, okay, it's just math, what does that same equation come to if it was just a top line revenue number? We're now seeing firms that the better firm 3 and 4 and even 5 times revenue. So still a far way off from 7 or 8, but a long way away from what was 2 times. And those numbers are really being sought after. And the way the companies are affording it is because of their growth rate, right? So their company stock is worth significantly more. They're growing the business itself. They're acquiring the business. They're acquiring the talent and the client assets. And then they're growing that business once it's on their platform at a much greater rate than it was growing beforehand. Mm-hmm. So all of that together is a long-winded answer to your question of how are they affording this? Well, they're affording it because they're able to drive efficiencies down into the business that allows advisors to be better advisors for their clients, more focused advisors for their clients, growing their business. And the overall acquisition strategy on top of that organic growth strategy is driving that growth rate, which then again, growth rate drives price. So that's really the formula that we're seeing in the marketplace.